I mean, X4...
fun, too.
X4 is a perfectly fine game.
Yeah. X5, X6... There's things I didn't like about them, but... I enjoyed X6. I literally enjoyed X6.
I thought X6
was okay. How can I say it? I don't want to cuss because I assume... Sorry, it's recording. X6, X7, it was just cluster and control. I mean, the 2D bits is fine. Okay. That's until you go to the 3D. I've been playing Last Crank, Megaman was playing him.
Well,
this is the transformation ability was. You have to tell me, make sure you don't kill the enemy before you can stop me.
Well, but Kevin was Axel. I thought he
was Axel. Making the voice of Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer in X7. He had a better voice in X8, and he was actually a somewhat better character.
Yeah. That was fire, too. That's taking a lot of
Burn to the ground. Burn to the ground.
It doesn't look good. The gameplay is okay. It just looks ugly. And the X armor thing. It makes it more. I didn't really like it.
Burn to the ground. His voice.
Burn to... Yo, yeah, you're talking about X7 again, isn't he?
Now let's talk about X8.
I just didn't like the armor system in X8.
Okay.
No, that's when it became enjoyable.
Avalanche Yeti stage and Gigavolt Man of War stages were bad.
I hated those. The bike stage, that was kind of stupid. The air stage, those were stages were stupid. It should have been a nice record stage. Now, it would have been nice to have the aesthetic of that. Then again, that X stage, because I think it was Yeti stage, it might be a certain stage in X stage. 4 and 5.
Just Stingray and Volt Fraction stage.
Don't remind me of those two things. Those things gave me nightmares. Especially when trying to get the heart.
And the set thing. We can agree that X6 had a great soundtrack.
I do like the boss. I did enjoy the boss.
X8 boss theme was the best in the series.
Not the beginning part. Not when you get them in the pinch part. I enjoy the pinch part. Because you know they're going to... What's the words I'm looking for? You know they're going to heat up the action a little bit. And bring out new moves.
Now, for the best game of the Mega Man X series, Mega Man X Command Mission.
RPG. Didn't enjoy it. Beat it on day one.
Whoa.
I spent hours playing that game. Then again, I already had a hint for it. A guidebook for it, too.
Luminae.
Yeah.
Luminae sucks. Never.
Never.
Yes.
What?
I think the whole Mega Man series. Well, you forgot to mention one final of the class. Well, I won't count this as a class.
That was fun. I liked it.
I know it doesn't count, but
I liked it for what it was.
It was a fan game. And it was actually good to play, to be honest.
It was fun. Sagat flip said. But Sagat is Mega Man. And they did it. Fun fact, if you use an E-Tank against Akuma, it restores his health.
Yes, it does.
You cannot use E-Tanks against Akuma.
Because Akuma will restore his health, and he'll also have... And his Raging Demon's a one-hit kill.
It's so awesome.
Yeah, that's true. You just want to get hit by it just to see it.
I know I did.
One remake on the classic series, though.
Oh yeah, Mega Man Power.
Now they should have. Now those issues. I wanted to play that on the Vita. They couldn't get the emulator. So it stuck on the PSP, but it was enjoyable for what it was. You know that voice actor was also part of the American Vengeance? Yeah, the normal part too.
I just play it.
I don't think you can play it. What? No, you can't play it. That's right. I can probably get away with doing it whenever we play more.
And now let's get Mega Man Legends.
There's three. I was really, the reason why I bought the 3DS is I was hoping for 3. I wanted 3 to happen.
Everybody did.
Yeah, and I guess the fallout with Capcom and all that.
Yep.
Cost 3.
Indeed it did.
Yeah, so. And people still demand they have 3 made.
That happened
when that brought up Mighty Number 9.
Now let's talk about
I'll give you that.
Torch Man, you fire man.
Yeah, you meant fire. Well, fire always looked like a torch, though, to be honest.
Yeah. Oh, and let's not forget about Blaster, man. In the English camp of Mega Man and Two Warriors, they renamed Bomb Man to Blaster Man due to 9/11.
I got the Mega Man game. I think I found the worst Mega Man game. I just thought about this.
Mega Man
Dog. Damn, that's just the Dog Spot. If you have access to... I actually played the both when I was younger. They were unenjoyable, yeah. You have to ask yourself, why were these made? Of course, then again, you're putting a PC game on a Nintendo. Alright, I got that back. A Nintendo game on the PC.
Now let's talk about the Mega Man sequel.
Okay, that Iron Man, that was pretty good.
Indeed.
Yeah, it was pretty good. The first one was pretty hard.
One was a little rough around the edges.
Yeah, treating a lot of that out.
I felt the series got better and better for every game.
You just wanted to know what happened
afterwards. Indeed.
3! I was lucky to get the computer cards for 3. Although now, with selection, you don't have to gather them all.
Also, that's a big move. Mega Man 2 would be better than 4. If you like a game that you can.
Yep.
Yeah, I did know that.
Still, why? Give the Bad Network series. Give the Bad Network series a chance.
Yeah.
Give the Bad Network series a chance.
I will at some point. But I'm not lazy.
Basically, it's No Vision Zero series is another universe in the What If series that's based off of the indie Mega Man's engine of 5.
Yep.
And 6. Alone 6.
Yeah,
that's
the
basis
of
that is.
Damn, I'm not blocking correctly. I thought it was okay.
I didn't want to be in Zero 3, I believe it was.
Yeah. Yeah.
I wish that you could have seen original.
Yes.
Right.
Yes. Everybody mentions that Omega. It should have been original X
Zero. Or at least redesigned.
It was sweet. I wish there was a sequel to that, actually.
I wish there was a third game.
Good match, man. Red earned that one. Considering how I bullied the rest of
I do have Advent, and I do have,
stupid. No, Advent was the first one. Second, I did enjoy both. I did really enjoy both. I want more.
Favorite Metroidvania-ish.
I think the first one. I think the first one paid homage to the original Mega Man X, though.
Not really.
I think. Well,
there was a high. There was a highway level.
From the original Mega Man X.
And then and the sequel Advent left on such a cliffhanger on hard mode. That is all.
I think there was supposed to be a cartoon of that.
I didn't really hear any puns of an animated series, but man, that ending, what left me wanting a sequel. That they left it wide open for a damn ending. I mean, it was bothered. Like the timeline.
First time I ever seen
no comment.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. Like we said earlier, it's like an over-glorified version of the Battle Man.
Wow.
No comment because I never played them. If it matters, I watched somebody play all of them. No, I watched somebody else on Twitch. He played every single Mega Man game that he was able to play throughout the series.
I know who you're talking about. I think I know who you're talking about, but I forget the name. I know who you're talking about.
He had a death counter as well. He recorded all of his deaths in every Mega Man game he played. He's not really that well known, but he goes by the name of Mojo Rick.
Now let's talk about
Sudden
Cup.
Street Fighter. You know about that series too well.
Yeah, he had the. Zero had to explain to me what was Remy to me on Wednesday.
Yes.
It was the point of that night.
Yeah, Remy was pretty much, you know, he went through his thing by doing something that he despised.
Well, we know who is the main character in the Street Fighter series already.
Yeah.
Yeah, basically. Alex is basically partially a main character.
Alex was. He is passing of the torch for the new generation. And well.
It was talking about Ryu, the Sasuke Hada, and the
Let's talk about the.
And of course, Mike.
Ah, the one with the really bad controls, where Hadouken is commanded to pull one off, two of them to kill an opponent. And a more time to show you can actually one-shot Sagat.
If you can nail him.
To be honest, the Tatsu was the hardest thing to perform in that game. And it sucks, too, for the record. The Turbo CD, if you play it on the Turbo graphics, the Turbo CD version, good LSD there. And it established a few characters that would reappear later on in the series. Who you can forgot. Aegon.
Birdie.
And Eager. Even Eager came back.
Eagle and Capcom.
Yes, sir. Part 2.
Or was Capcom. It Street... No, Street Fighter Alpha 3 was later. Right?
Yeah, and then he also was a bonus. Mm-hmm. Yes, him, Yun, and Mackie. Yeah.
Then, on the PSP version, Ingrid.
Yep. Ingrid. He's the official canon.
And now, let's talk about the most iconic fighting game in the decade. That would get lots of clickbait. And we didn't want that to come out. Street Fighter 2!
You mean Ultra Street Fighter 2, the final challengers?
We're talking
about the
Ultra Street Fighter 2. Violent Ken.
Bison Possessed Ken.
I'll be honest with you, Violent Ken actually interests me. But I saw a gameplay bit of it afterwards, and then I thought otherwise. They aim a dash. Something that the rest of the characters in the series can't do that. That's like a game mechanic that was added in other fighting games, but to add it in the Street Fighter, the Super Turbo engine, and then they made his hurricane kick lateral instead of like,
you know, horizontal.
Mm-hmm. And then like in the air, and then they gave him auto combo super, which was. It's pretty much a reused auto combo that ends with a Shoryuken.
Wasn't that his super combo in
SNK versus Capcom Chaos?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was what he was
originally.
In
Ringo, he doesn't really look right.
Nope.
He does not look that like the character that appears in Super Turbo.
Indeed.
Even with the Ugon graphics.
Yep. Freaking copy and paste it that.
Yes.
It's disgusting. I mean, this is Capcom we're talking about, but yeah.
And again, people are gonna say, when is it coming out on... If that thing comes out on a...
I will be hyped if it comes out on Steam.
Most likely
Steam. Well, I don't mind if I saw on PS4. I only say that because, well, I don't have PS4 yet.
I don't hear it either. I might skip 5 and just get Marvel's Capcom Ultimate. Infinite.
Now let's talk about the Street Fighter 2 upgrades.
I think people love Champion Edition a lot. Is it Champion Edition people love, or is it... Hype.
It's either Hyper Fighting or Champion Edition, and then there's the New Challengers.
New Challengers and Turbo.
It's mostly Super Turbo, but there is a few crowd of people that do like Champion Edition.
And don't forget Hyper Street Fighter 2, the anniversary.
Oh yeah, that's a version where you can use every single version of the Street Fighter 2 characters
all the way under, yeah. And for God's sake, the people that just use Old Sagat.
Ah, yeah. Old Sagat.
Now let's talk about Street Fighter 2, the animated movie.
That was...
We all know how that
was good! By today's standards, not so much, but back then, it was great. The one with the Chinese Vegas.
Yeah, because we had the live action movie, not to mention the game that came with it.
Yeah.
And I guess Capcom was like, fuck this.
Indeed.
We'll just make the animated movie, and we just want the animated. I was so pissed when I watched that movie. My brother actually got the animated movie.
Now let's talk about the anime side of Street Fighter Street Fighter Alpha.
Oh yeah, Alpha.
AKA
that's supposed to be a remake of one.
Yes, Alpha was like
that was Alpha. That took place a little after one.
Yeah,
I made a mistake.
It's like a continuation. That explains why you...
Alpha 1 tried to do little glitches, and no one wrote attention. You can change something like that, Alpha 1.
Yes. Yes, you can do light, medium, to heavy in the first one.
And you got air blocking, and you had air... For those probably watch our movie. Guess where all that came from first. Exactly.
Yep. The very first one.
Even the very first one had air blocks.
Yep.
I think, yes.
It did.
Yeah, it did.
Yep. It sure did.
EX moves. Well, a lot of the series owe more to Darkstalkers. And we had this discussion about 2 years. Out of the Street Fighter series nowadays and Marvel series owe a lot to Darkstalkers.
It sure does.
Yeah, because Darkstalkers started chain combo system, but at least you can't pursuit attack, but basically it made up the awkward metal attack.
Yep.
Let's talk about Alpha 2 and
2. Alpha 2 goes back to basics.
Indeed. And custom combos. And a godlike soundtrack.
Yeah. Oh yeah, where did Alpha Counters come from? And I don't remember.
Alpha Counters were the first one as well.
Yeah, Alpha Counters were the first one as well, but
they were also
they
a lot
never
better.
Used Vader in this game.
Yeah.
Any of the Darkstalkers, they never used me. I found that on the hard way. Great game. I kind of whiffed the character theme.
Oh yeah.
But I did not enjoy the game.
Some of them were okay.
I like Bison's Grave Edition. The Bison theme, though. Although I did that thing you told me to do.
Yes.
Holy crap, you were right. He cannot block for any light.
Told you.
Cody's light.
I told you.
He cannot block.
He's free to Cody's
I literally got a
pick.
Double perfect on Omega Bison. Oh,
yes, sir.
He does not block well.
He's free to Cody. Secretly the best Street Fighter character ever. Because he's actually Street Fighter.
Yeah, bad AI. That's my fault.
I was talking about the pop when Street Fighter was going 3D before SMP.
Street Fighter EX? It was alright, EX.
It was alright. I mean, EX had its thing. I mean,
it had a
people always.
Great-